हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ एंटायरली न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ द सेम यूनिट, दैट इज यूनिट 1. टुडे एरियाज ऑफ कंसर्न और द टॉपिक्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग टाइप्स ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, अबाउट डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैटिस्टिक्स, इन्फ्रेंशियल स्टैटिस्टिक्स, एंड वट आर द डिफरेंट मेजर्स इन केस ऑफ डिस्क्रिप्टिव स्टैटिस्टिक्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद आर फर्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड इट्स टाइप्स. So we already saw in our last lecture what exactly statistics is and what does it mean. So let's start with the first type of statistics, that is descriptive statistics. Now descriptive statistics can be defined as, like, descriptive statistics uses the data to provide description of the population, either numerical calculation, graphs or table. So any data which It means any data which we want to describe in the form of graphs or any tabulation kind of data, that is considered as descriptive statistics. So descriptive statistics mainly focus upon main characteristics of data. Now what do you mean by main characteristics? Like, it will show you only the characteristics of a data which is more important or on which we need to focus. Ultimately what it is giving you a graphical or the numerical summary of the data. So we can take the example of descriptive statistics as it. You can read the example. Suppose we want to study the height of the students of a classroom, then in descriptive statistics we can record the height of each and every person of the class and categorize it as maximum, minimum and average height. Now what does it mean? It means suppose I have a class of 30 students, then what descriptive statistics will tell me? It is like I need to record, if I need to analyze the height of all these students in my class, then in case of descriptive statistics, I need to calculate or measure the height of each and every person. Like if I have 30 students in my class, then I need to record the, need to measure the height of every person, and by considering the height of every person, then I can declare or then I can conclude that the maximum height of my class is 5.9, for example, and the minimum height of my class is 5.1. So this conclusion or this result, how I am getting this result or conclusion is, what I am doing, I am just measuring the height of, I am taking the height of each and every individual, and by looking over all the data, by looking over all the heights of all 30 students, I am concluding the maximum, minimum and average height of my class, of the students of my class. So the second example in the similar manner we can take it as, suppose we want to manufacture t-shirt for all my students in my batch. For example, if I have 15 students in my batch and I just need to manufacture t-shirt, for example, obviously if I need to manufacture t-shirt, I should have a rough idea about what should be the measurement of the students, so that I can give the measurement to my tailor, and accordingly that according to the size, the tailor is going to stitch the t-shirts. Now the question here also arises about the size. So in case of descriptive statistics also, what I need to do, I need to take the measurement of all my 15 students. For example, whatever the size is, 40, 42, 45, 46. Then according to the size I have taken, considering all the data of 15 students, I need to conclude with the measurement as maximum, minimum and average size. Now, in this case, now I will be able to decide that yes, the maximum size of the t-shirt should be 48, for example, and minimum size should be 40, and 45 should be the average. Now this is the conclusion. Whatever statistics will give you a conclusion in the form of the method you are adopting. If we are using a descriptive statistics, then in that case we need to conclude by considering each and every person or each and every data present in a data set. So I think I am clear with this topic, descriptive statistics. Coming on to the next one, that is inferential statistics. Now, if we talk about inferential statistics, So you can easily identify or understand with the diagram what it is representing. It is representing a population. Since we have discussed earlier also, a population is the data set on which we want to do a survey, or from which we need to conclude something. So from population we will be retrieving a sample. Again, sample is the set which is extracted from the population, but it should be extracted in the manner that it should represent the whole population in an efficient manner. Now, if we talk about the inferential statistics, then it can be defined as, like, inferential statistics mainly generalizes larger data sets and applies probability to draw the conclusion. Now, how it is applying probability to draw the conclusion? It is making a assumption kind of thing, or you can say probability is sort of an assumption kind of thing. It is assuming that yes, this would be a result considering the following data. Like, if we are considering the same example in a class which we categorize. So we can take the example of a class in which we can categorize the height as tall, medium and small. Now in this case, that is in case of inferential statistics, what happens? We need to, same example we can take, if I am having a class of 30 students, in this case I don't have to measure the size of each and every person. I will just, by looking at the sample, I will just conclude that 5.9 will be the maximum height and 5.1 will be the minimum height. But in this case, or 5.5 will be the average height of a class. But in this case, I am not going to measure height of each and every person. So the difference is, in case of descriptive, we need to measure the height of each and every data set, height of each and every person in a class. And if we take the example of a data set, we need to observe each and every data in a data set. Now, in case of inferential, we don't need to take each and every data in the data set. We just need to overview the data, and we just need to conclude our result that this would be the result. As in the example we considered, we are just concluding, yes, 5.9, seeing the persons or the students, we are just concluding that 5.9 is the maximum height and 5.1 is the minimum height. So I hope I am clear with this topic. Moving ahead to our next topic, that is again a very important topic, that is measures in descriptive statistics. Now, if we talk about measures in descriptive statistics, then they are broadly classified as two: measures of central tendency and measures of variability. We'll start with the first one, that is measures of central tendency. Measures of central tendency are classified as mean, median and mode. And I hope you must all have heard about these terms whenever you have studied statistics in your school or college life, because it is the most easiest and the common term, and pretty easy to understand. So we'll have a quick discussion on these following terms. Let's start with the first one, that is median. Now, when we are talking about the term median, then it can be defined as a measure of average of all the values in the sample. What does it mean, measures of all the values in the sample? In this particular case, we need to take all the values of the sample and we need to divide it by the total value. For example, you can take the example of the cars mentioned in the table. We have a list of 5 cars. Datsun, Alto, Toyota, Ford and Centro, and we have a list of MPG, cylinder and displacement. For example, if I need to calculate the mean of the term displacement of the car, then how I am going to do that? I am going to add all the values associated in the displacement of all the cars, that is 160 plus 108 plus 160 plus 160 plus 150 divide by, I am going to divide it by the total value. Since the number of cars are 5, So I will be dividing it by 5. So the mean of the displacement will be 160 plus 108 plus 160 plus 160 plus 150 divided by the whole term. So in this way, whatever value I am getting, that would be the mean of the displacement. So it was very pretty easy to understand. Let's move ahead to our next topic, that is median. Now, when we are talking about median can be defined as a measure of central value of the sample set. Now, what does it mean by the central value of the sample set? Central value means you can consider the following list. When you consider this list, you will find 9 elements, 5, 13, 9, 7, 1, 9, 2, 9 and 11. Now the very first step which we need to do is we need to convert the list into the ascending order, which I did in my example. I have converted the list in the ascending order. When we convert this list in the ascending order, I'll get a numbers according to the from lowest to the highest. So my very first step for calculating mean will be to convert the list to the ascending order, which I did. Now I have converted the list to the ascending order, and now I need to calculate the median. For calculating the median, I need to calculate the middle term, and for evaluating the middle term, I need to exit or I need to eliminate same number of terms from left and right side. So what I did, I eliminated 4 numbers from the left side and 4 numbers from the right side. Okay, 1, 2, 5, 7 are the 4 numbers towards my left, and 9, 9, 11, 11, 13 are the numbers towards my right. So I did, I just did elimination of 4 numbers from both the sides, and thus I am getting the center number as 9. So in this case, the median will be 9, since my center number is 9. Now this is the example in which the data set is having an odd number of values, so it is pretty easy to calculate the middle value. What in case if I am getting a data set of even numbers? Like for example, if I have 8, 10, whatever even numbers, then in that case we need to take 2 middle values, because you will be getting 2 middle values in that case. So if we take it, for example, if I add 14 in this list, then the middle values will be 9, 9. So my median will be 9 plus 9, that is 18. So in this way we will be calculating the median of the data set. So I hope I am clear with this topic also. Moving ahead to our last topic, that is mode. Now again, mode is the third and the most important part in this. It indicates the value that are most recurrent in the sample set. Mode basically represent the value which is occurring or recurring more, or which is more in occurrence. The example we can take of the same cylinders used in most cars. We can go back to the same example. In this case, we need to find the type, which type of cylinder is in more popularity or is in use more. When you see the table, you will have a look of there are two types of cylinders used, 6 and 4. 6 type of cylinder is used 3 times, that is by 3 cars, and 4 type of cylinder is used by 2 cars, that is Alto and Centro. So which type of cylinder is occurring more? 6 type. So the median of the, the mode of the what of our data set will be 6, since the occurrence of 6 is more as compared to 4. So I hope I am clear with this topic also. So that's all for today's lecture, students. Measures of spread, we have measures of central tendency, we have seen. Now in our next topic, we will be covering the measures of variability shown. Okay, so see you with our next lecture, with our next topic soon. Goodbye.